What's going on YouTube? Card Collector 2 coming at you here. I'm getting ready to sub a bunch of stuff to PSA, and this is an order I've just been putting together for a little while. It is mostly vintage stuff. I don't mess a whole lot with vintage, and I'll be honest, I'm not expecting, you know, tens on a lot of this stuff. Maybe some of the pro set stuff that I'll show here in a second of like Aikman and Sanders and guys like that, but a lot of this stuff I'm not expecting complete tens on. It's just, I think it's better off to grade them than try to sell them raw. A lot of graded stuff sells in my shop. And I just, honestly, people like graded cards better than raw cards in most situations. So that's why I'm subbing some of these cards. Again, I am by far not the graded expert by any means. But yeah, gonna get ready to send this in. This is about 80 cards, I think. I haven't exactly counted, but for those that have asked me before, I just wanted to plug this now that I got this in. I run my submissions through Clay Cards on Instagram. As you can see, there's his email. There's his Instagram name. But he is who I use for all of my PSA subs. I never had this business card to be able to plug this before in my videos. But Clay is who I use for basically every PSA sub that I do. So this will be going to him here very soon. So I'm just going to flip through these real quick just to show you guys what I'm sending in. Feel free to give me your feedback in the comments below. Totally not a problem. Whether you agree or disagree with any of these, like I said, I'm open to any and all feedback. So definitely let me know what you think. But Daryl Green, I believe this is 84 tops. I think this is like Marino and Elway's rookie year. But Daryl Green, pretty clean. It's in pretty good shape. So again, I'm not the expert on grading vintage, so I could totally be way off here. I think these got a little out of order. Yeah, here we go. I say I know there's way more of these. All right, so in total, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 Troy Aikman Pro Set rookies. So there was about 20 of them I had, and I picked through, and I think these ones are all pretty good. So I'm gonna give these 10 a shot and see what happens. But they're not really worth much raw. If they come back 10s, they're definitely more than the price of grading. So figured I'd give those a shot. And then Sanders, there was actually like 40 Sanders I went through, and these are definitely the cleanest ones. These are through a deal in the shop. Again, not sure how many of these will 10. But they're in really good shape. So I would imagine there's probably, it ends up being, you know, 70-30 on 10s versus 9s, in favor of 10s. But again, vintage isn't my, my specialty, so, hard to really say, but they look pretty clean to me. I'll let you guys get a quick view on and what you think. Little white up there. So yeah, like I said, tough to say for sure, but these cards are super tough to grade. If you know anything about this set, this is 85 tops. Ones that I actually learned a lot about is that these are hard to grade because there's typically a lot of white on the edges. But these ones are actually pretty good. Montana's not huge, but as you can see, they're in pretty good shape. So I guess we'll see. Just 110 out of these would be awesome, but you never really know. But there's 5 total. Of those going in. I believe this is Campbell's rookie. I don't think it's his second year, but again, vintage isn't not my forte. So just kind of wanted to show some of this off. I know this is Simpson's rookie. I think this is probably a 6. If I had to guess, it's pretty clean. But I'm typically pessimistic with grading vintage stuff because, again, it's not something I know a whole lot of. But Jim Kelly, USFL, I think this is 85. I think there's a first one in 84. Or maybe this is 84. Maybe I have them backwards. But Jim Kelly, as you can tell, don't really know a whole lot about the vintage market. It's just something I'm kind of new to. Centered pretty well in the Franco Harris. This Doug Williams is actually really, really clean. This is a tough card to grade, but going to send it in, try, hope for the best. So a lot of this stuff is, again, this is Craig rookie. This one's got great color on it. it's in pretty good shape. So hopefully that ends up tenon. Duke Snider. Again, I mean, you'll see on a lot of this stuff, it's not in the best shape. This has got a crease from side to side. But again, the graded stuff actually moves pretty well for me. So I'd rather just have this graded than try to sell it raw. I love PSA holders, and they typically translate into sales in my shop. So gonna send that in. Hank Aaron, from, was it 76 tops? So not great shape. This Ripken's actually in pretty decent shape. From 85 tops, pretty good. Here's your Yastrzemski. Again, I love grading stuff, so some of the stuff I'm just willing to take chances on. 67 tops. Actually, it doesn't look terrible. Was it 62? 68. See? Obviously, I'm absolutely horrible at this. Willie Mays. Not a great corner, so this is probably a 4. A 3. I mean, it's beat up, but still gonna give it a shot. This is actually in decent shape. I mean, if you look at the corners, they're not too bad. So that's why I'm sending that in. Some 86 tops. Again, another set that's really, really tough. These are actually in a pretty great shape. Peyton. Again, that's not white corner. That's part of the design. But you can see that these are in pretty good shape for 86 tops. So Dorsett, Peyton, and Dickerson. Then you got what I believe is a second year Marino. Again, I'm not 100% sure because that's 88, so that's definitely not second year. It's like fourth year. Franco Harris. Otis Anderson. You can just see that some of these are in like good shape. This is definitely not one of the better ones, but I think it has a shot to like 7. Maybe 6. John Riggins, rookie. Tony Dorsett. Bold color. Sharp corner, so we'll see. 88 tops, right? 87 tops Marino, or Montana, excuse me. But pretty good shape there. A couple of these, I think one of these is probably an 8, and one of them might have a shot at a 9. Staubach and Fouts from 80 tops. Pretty clean. Jim Kelly, it's definitely off-centered, but again, Hall of Fame rookies that are graded typically move pretty well. So send that in. Bo Jackson tops. Pretty clean. This is actually one of the first mantles I ever bought in the shop. Again, I'm not expecting a high grade by any stretch of the imagination here. I just like mantle stuff and like getting it slabbed. So that's what I'm doing with this one. It's like one of those play ball cards. I think it's like 68 or 64 tops. It's later, it's from the 60s, I believe, but it's like a playing card, like a playing trading card. Is this the 62? I don't remember. Again, baseball, old vintage, especially baseball, is definitely not my strength, but some cool looking, some cool cards. I remember this guy like actually sells decent. I don't know much about Tim McCarver, but I was looking these up, and I think this is like a 3 or a 4, and it sells actually decent, I believe. Again, some of this stuff's been in semi-regis for 2 months now since I bought the store. But so there's probably some rhyme or reason at the time. But we'll see. Ricky Henderson, rookie, pretty clean, but nothing super great. Probably a 7. Some 89 score. Actually, I ended up buying a couple of sets, and there's a couple of these in here. They're pretty clean. Aikman, Deion Sanders, Derek Thomas, and then 2 Barry Sanders. There's the look at 1, and there's the look at another. So, a couple of tens out of those wouldn't hurt. And then you got Thurman Thomas from 89 score as well. As you can see, pretty clean. A couple of, what are these, 70, no idea. Honestly, not even a guess, but Steve Carlton and Joe Morgan with the traded symbol on them. Pretty clean. Some 70 tops. There's quite a few of this. I ended up buying a whole collection of it, basically, and picked out some of the ones that are in better shape. So you got a league leaders, Aaron, May, and McCovey. And you got a Joe Morgan. A little off-centered, but overall pretty crisp. Then you got a Bill Mazeroski. Again, pretty decent shape. A little white on the top corner. And possibly something on the A. Nope, never mind. So, Veta Pinson. I mean, that card's in pretty good shape. Some of the Sporting News cards, or the All-Star. Danny McLean. Pete Rose. Pretty off center there on the bottom, or top to bottom. Johnny Bench. It was actually a card that sells pretty well. It's not going to grade the best, but still pretty clean. There's a Rod Carew, All-Star. And then a Sam McDowell All-Star. So, pretty decent. I actually just got one of these in the other day that was signed. The signature's faded, but it was actually signed, not the facsimile. But 71 Topps Johnny Bench. This is kind of cool. Sandy Koufax, Bunning, and is it Bob Veil? Veal? Vele? No idea. I don't know much about him. But pretty clean. Again, not expecting many, you know, tens on this kind of stuff. These came in a deal. These aren't in great shape, especially the Spawn, the Matthews. But again, I love having cards slabbed. So that's what I'm doing with some of this stuff. But Red Crest, this is actually not in the worst shape. The other two are in horrible shape. But again, I just wanted them slabbed. Here's the Matthews. You can see it is brutal. It is a PSA 1 for sure. I mean, it's got like chewed up corners, but still. This is super old. I love old stuff, like vintage stuff, and having them slab. So that's what I'm gonna do. And then the Warren Spahn, definitely better shape than the Matthews, but that's it's just because it does have a corner that's chewed up. But you can see it's got creases. It's not in great shape, but again, not everything I said that's vintage is 10 worthy. I like having some stuff slabbed. And they got a Hank Aaron 59 All Star. And then, last but not least, a Johnny Bench. People have debated that this is a rookie. It's obviously not doing well. The front looks clean. It's got the eye appeal, right? Centered pretty well. Corners aren't awful. They're not great, but some chunks out of the back. Just, again, I don't have it slabbed, but not really going to be worth a whole lot. It's just, I think it has a better chance of selling with a PSA grade on it than it does selling raw as is like that. So, again, I like having cards off at PSA, getting them back. Just that feeling is fun. I enjoy it. Again, regardless if these cards 10, 9, 6, 7, you know, it's the name of the game. It's fun to get PSA orders back, have graded cards available for sale. So that's kind of what this is. But that's all I got, guys. Stay tuned for some more PSA submission videos. And as always, if you guys have questions about PSA, you know who I use, Clay Cards. So there's his email. There's his contact info. So feel free to check them out. But that is all I got, guys. Talk soon. Peace.